Longtime listener. How you doing, Tom?
Thank you.
All right. Hey, I got a question about co-signing on a loan for a home.
All right. Don't do it. Go ahead.
Don't do it?
Yeah.
Anyway, I want to co-sign a loan with a friend.
Okay.
And then after the closing costs and everything, in about 3 or 4 months, can I take my name off the loan?
Absolutely, positively not. No, Curtis, your name will be on that loan until the day it's paid off, whether that's 5 years or 30 years from now. If your friend ever makes a late payment, it's going to show up on your credit report. If he ever quits making payments at all, then they're going to do a mortgage foreclosure, and that's really going to ding your credit. So, Curtis, that's why I started all this conversation by telling you, don't do it. Now, Curtis, if you're going to ignore my advice and going to do it anyway, Curtis, I'm going to say this. Curtis, make sure at least then your name is on a deed to the property as well. If you're going to take this risk, well, you might as well have your name on a deed as well. If you don't do anything, they're just going to put your name on the mortgage and not on the deed to the property. Curtis, does that make sense to you?
Yes, it does.
Have I told you?
Without my name on the property, the deed on the property, if the other person doesn't pay, then they own the condo, but I just own the mortgage then.
You got it, Curtis. So, Curtis, have I turned your head around? Are you going to not do this loan now?
Well, I'll have to talk with her.
Oh.
Anyway.
Is she a girlfriend, Curtis?
No, it's a friend, you know, a close friend, family, like.
Look, Curtis, I've been a lawyer for 35 years, and for 35 years I've been telling people, do not co-sign mortgages and do not co-sign car loans. Even if it's your kids, don't do it, Curtis. That's my recommendation to you. If you're going to do it, Curtis, at least put your name on a deed as well. Good luck to you, Curtis. Bye-bye.